So let us watch one more video for the frequency polygon. In this video, we are going to see question number 2 of the...
So my dear students, here we are going to see question number 2 for the frequency polygon. Draw a frequency polygon to represent the following data. Class intervals are given 0 to 9, 9 to 18, 18 to 27, 27 to 36, 36 to 45, and their respective frequencies are given 9, 15, 6, 12, 18. So let us see how can we do it. As I have told you earlier, first of all we need to draw three columns. In the first column we'll write the class intervals which are given in the question. So class interval. But as I told you, you have to skip one of the rows and after that you can write, because we need to write there something else. 0 to 9, 9 to 18, 18 to 27, 27 to 20, 36, and 36 to 45. So this is what we have. Okay, these are the class intervals which are given to us. Here we need to write the class mark. Class mark. And the last one, we have the frequency. So let us write the respective frequencies which are given. 0 to 9's frequency is given as 9. This is given as 15, 6, 12, and 18. Okay. Now what we need to do is, we have to write a class interval before this with a class size of 9, 9, because you can see here we have a gap of class size of 9, 9. So before this we have minus 9 to 0, and after this we'll have 45 to 54. Okay, so one class interval before the one which is given and one class interval after the one which is given. Now we'll find the class marks. Add them both and divide by 2. So this one comes minus 4.5. Between 0 to 9, 0 plus 9 by 2, so it comes 4.5. Okay, and this comes 13.5. This one 22.5. Okay, you can keep on adding 9, 9 also, and you can do. So it's the same thing, 31.5. Okay, then comes 40.5. Then comes 49.5. So these are the class marks. Okay, and the frequency for the first class interval will be 0, and for the last one which we have taken will also be 0. Now let us see how can we draw it in the graph. So first we'll draw the x-axis. Remember, here we need negative as well, and as I told you, whenever it's from 0, take the class intervals and don't take the class marks, because in that case you will not get the origin if you take the class marks and do here. So I have taken this all. This is y-axis, this is x-axis, here you can write x dash, this is 0, and here I write 9, the next one is 18, in 2 cm I have taken 18, then we have 27, then 36, then 45, and last one 54. And this side, don't forget to write, this is minus 9, and after that we have minus 18, but no need of writing that, this will do. Okay, now what we need to do? In the y-axis, we have to take the highest which is required is 18. Okay, so you can take 2, 4, 6, 8 if you want. Okay, in 2 cm I'm taking 2, 4, will it go? Let us see whether we have enough space or not. 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. No, we don't have enough space. So what we can do is, you can take here as 2, 4, 6, 8 also, and you can do if you want. Okay? So I'm taking 2, 4, 6, 8 in 1 centimeter. You can do. Or if you want to use the full graph, usually we should use the full graph, okay? And do it. So you can take the full graph and take as I have taken 2, 4, 6, 8 can be taken. Or else I'm taking here like this 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. Now this is okay. 18. We are getting 18. So 1 cm is equal to 2 units I have taken. Okay? Always try to make the graph bigger. Now these are the class intervals. So just write class interval. Class interval. Give an arrow. And this we have the frequency. So just write frequency. Okay, so as it is given, so you have to write. Now, how do we mark? First one is minus 4.50, isn't it? If you see this, minus 4.50. So where is minus 4.5? Here we have minus 4.5, between 0 and minus 9. So this is the point minus 4.50. There's nothing to calculate, just the middle one of that. Then the next we have 4.59. You can see this is 4.59. So this is 4.5. Where is 9? 9 is here, between 10 and 8. This is 4.5, 4.5 is 9. Okay, then we have 13.5, 15. We have 15 here, between 14 and 16, this is 13.5 is 15. Okay, then we have 22.56, this one. Then we have 31.5 is 12. Okay, where do we have 12? Let us see, 12 is already directly given there. So this is their 12. Then we have 40.5 is 18. 40.5 is 18. This is 40.5 is 18. And last, 49.5 is 0. Okay, now we need to join them all by using a ruler. Remember to join one by one in sequence. Okay, this came. Then this. And lastly, we have this. So this is your frequency polygon, but you need to write, as I have told you, this coordinate is minus 4.50. So write it here. This is minus 4.50. What about this? This is 4.59. So 4.5, 9. What about this? This is 13.515. So write here, 13.5, 15. And this one, you know, is 22.5, 6. So 22.5, 6, the coordinate of this point, and the coordinate of this point will be 31.512. So let us write 31.512. Okay, what about this? This is 40.5, 18, and this one is 49.5, 0. Okay, now what is left? Scale, SCLE, scale. In x-axis, what do we have? 2 cm is 9 units. Okay, 2 cm we have taken as 9. So in x-axis, 2 cm equal to 9 units. What about y-axis? In y-axis, 2 cm is 4 units. In y-axis, we have 2 cm is equal to 4 units. You can even write 1 cm is equal to 2 units also. So this is your frequency polygon for question number 2. Take a closer view. Okay. Thank you. See you. Bye-bye.